Wow, it's been a minute. And listen, I've been aching, getting physical, literal body pains to talk about this book. So I'm glad I'm finally here. What the secret is, if you wake up at 5 a.m. in the morning, what are you supposed to do? Who is the 5 a.m. club? What do you do when you're part of the 5 a.m. club? This book answered all of those questions for me. Come around. Hey, what's up? What's good? I am Lethukwenama. Very warm welcome back to my channel. Today we are starting a series of book reviews and I am flipping excited, and we're starting with one of my favorite books in the whole wild world. It is The 5 a.m. Club by Robin Sharma. So I grew up being an avid reader and kind of dissipated with time, and now I'm back at it, you know. In and out of my studies, I try to read and, you know, catch up on good books that I think will have a great impact on my life, just, you know, broaden my knowledge. So I've been aching, I've been getting physical body pains waiting to do this video about this book, man. I want to share this with you. I've learned some great gems from this and you need to know about them too. So if you're ready to improve your life, if you're all about self-help, self-motivation, and you need something there to constantly remind you of, you know, how great you are and why you need to invest in yourself every day, then this is the book for you. So stay tuned and hear what I have to say about it. So the summary of this book, it's essentially about two people that we're following. It's an entrepreneur and an artist. They're facing some struggles in their personal lives as well as their careers, which we all do, right? And so we get to follow them, see how are they actually going to change their lives. They have some goals. How do they set them? How do they go about achieving them? Do they actually achieve them at the end of the day? So that's essentially what the book is about. And they're being guided by these two people called the Spellbinder as well as Mr. Riley. So very interesting characters that you actually get to learn more about in the book, definitely. So I think you should definitely check it out. And it raises a whole lot of questions, like existential questions: why you're here, what your purpose in life is, and are you actually living up to that? And so yeah, so I really enjoyed that aspect. Without ruining too much of it, my general opinion of the book is that I'll start with the cons, right? I think, so the book took me 4 months to read, and I can explain before you judge. I think the beginning of the book takes long, man. He takes you on a ride and a ride and a ride and a ride, and you really aren't really getting the juice that you think you're going to get, because, you know, you're reading the 5 a.m. club, you want to know what's up, right? So I feel like Robin took his time, man, and, you know, you get into the background of the characters, where they are, where they're from, where they are in the careers, which is important, but it took too long. So for me, I was like, ah, okay, I'm getting tired of it. So I started reading another book, and then in between that, I was studying and reading another book. So yeah, it took me a bit. When I got to the juicy parts, I couldn't put it down. I couldn't, and I appreciated how clear the book is. So a lot of motivational stuff, say a lot of wishy-washy things, but miss the part of how do I implement this into my life. And Robin gave me that ABC 1-2-3 step by step, and that's exactly what I appreciate. It's very clear, it's very practical, you know what to do to improve your life. He tells you what you're supposed to do every day, and then he tells you, like, measure this after the certain period, do this every single day, make your goals like this, do this when you wake up, do this during the day. It's practical and it makes sense, and you should try it. So the four things that he focuses on in the book are called the four interior empires. So it's your mindset, your heart set, your soul set, and your health set. So the four different sets that you need to take care of. So I'm going to share two, like, parts of the books or gems that he shares in the book that I actually really, really loved, without ruining the book for you too much. So the first one is the 2020 formula, which I've implemented, and my life, I could literally see a difference in 30 days. I was like, wow, 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 it's working. So the first one is called the 2020 formula. So with the 2020 formula, it's the world-class morning routine that Robin Sharma has been teaching for about over 20 years. You know, he speaks about it lightly in The Monk Who Sold His Ferrari and a lot of his YouTube videos. And in this book, he goes into detail about it. So what it means is that you wake up at 5 a.m. every single day. And for the first 20 minutes, you exercise. Second 20 minutes, you meditate and journal. And the last 20 minutes, you'll be reading a book, listening to a podcast, to learning something new, and that is the victory hour in short. So, and then he gives you the details of how this helps. You know, when you're exercising, you're releasing endorphins, you're releasing happy hormones, you're starting your day on a good note, and you're meditating, getting your soul in the right place, your heart, your mind, you know, and you know, you're journaling, so you get to keep track of your emotions, of your goals, of what you want to do, where you are, your mindset, and you can always look back on that, right? So I have great respect for journaling, and it's helped me deal with a lot of things and also just track myself. And you know, I see a lot of things that I wrote like, oh, 2 years ago I actually said I wanted this, look at me now. So I think it feels good to be able to do that, you know, in retrospect, of course, but now I'm actively journaling. So yeah, that's the 2020 rule. And then the next one is the 90-91 rule. So what the 90-91 rule says is that for the first 90 minutes of every day, for 90 days, you focus on one task. So for 90 days, first 90 minutes, focus on one task, right? So he talks about 90 minutes of uninterrupted time. So this is a bit long for me, and my concentration span, like, it's that of a neonate, my guy. It's so bad. It is so bad. So I made this work for me. So as much as, you know, he gives you what to do, you can also just apply this and make it work for your life. So I separate the 19 minutes into 25 minute pockets, right? So I use the Pomodoro technique. So if you're interested in learning more about that, check this out. I actually have a study video where we get to study with each other for 100 minutes using the Pomodoro technique. So what I do with that is that I study for 25 minutes straight, take a 5 minute break, 25, 5 minute break, 25, 5 minute break. So it's not exactly 90 minutes, but it's around the same time that he's talking about. So I did that during exams and it worked like a charm. I knew that by 9 o'clock I've already put an hour 30 minutes of uninterrupted time into a certain subject or certain topic that I'm doing, and already you just feel productive, like the day is not even that far in yet and already you've done so much. So that was amazing for me. Definitely want you to try it out and let me know what you think. So Robin, thanks for that trick. I mean, I don't think it's something that no one can come up with, but like the way he put it and the way he encourages you to do it and then implementing it and seeing the results is just wowing. Okay, so I'm going to share two of my favorite quotes from the book with you. So they come from page 4 and 5. This is the Spellbinder speaking in the book. He says, "You were born into the opportunity as well as the responsibility to become legendary. You need to remember that your excuses are seducers, your fears are liars, and your doubts are thieves." World class begins where your comfort ends. That was a really beautiful quote. And then another one on page 16. He says, "You can fit in or you can change the world. You don't get to do both." And then to wrap it all up and share something that has been a general theme throughout the book is that, and something that I think you should note as you read the book and as you try implement measures to change your life, right? And improve who you are, what you do, and what the outcome of your life is as you chase your goals. This is it. All change is hard at first, messy in the middle, and gorgeous in the end. So out of these, which one is your favorite quote? Let me know. Oh yeah. So recommendation and rating time. Would I recommend this book? It's a big, big yes. What am I giving this book out of 5? Okay, let me tell you something first. Definitely recommend this book. Do it. If you are someone who wants to change your life, gain better habits, personal growth, improve the quality of your life, you know, reach your goals, get clear goal setting and be able to, you know, to measure that, look back and see how great you've done, increase your productivity and impact. This is the book for you. So this book is currently in the top 10 bestsellers. It's been like that in exclusive books for a couple of months now, almost a year actually. Yeah, it's been doing very well. So I definitely think you should go get it. I got mine in Take a Lot. It was on a sale at the time, or just a bit cheaper than it is now, because it's actually quite, you know, fast growing book, still in the top 10. So definitely get it. And so out of 5, I'm giving this book a 4.9, and literally that 0.1 is because of that lag that I told you about. Otherwise, I think it's a brilliant book. Go get it. Take home message time. So my take home message from this book is that part-time commitment gives part-time results, and that essentially small daily improvements results in stunning results at the end. If you're improving something daily, when you look back in a year's time, you would have done well. So I hope you enjoyed this book review. Let me know what you think. Are you interested in getting this book? Are you part of the 5 a.m. club already? Let's get chatting in the comments down below. Thank you for watching till the end. I appreciate you, and I'll see you on the next video. Keep well.